What up guys, it's Adrian from YouMotorcycle. I'm gonna do a super quick video talking about air-cooled versus liquid-cooled motorcycles. If you're asking this question, I'm assuming you're probably buying a motorcycle and you wanna figure out, why do we need cooling? How are they different? Which one's better? Which one's right for me? And which one would that guy on YouTube pick? So that's what I'm gonna be answering, and I'm gonna break it up into different little chapters. So if you look on the little timeline down here somewhere, you can click ahead to whatever part is most relevant to you. Because I'm going to start with this in a really simple fashion. Why do we need it? Well, if you think about any machine, whether it's a motor vehicle or even just a laptop, they have fans, they have ways of cooling things down. Anytime you're burning anything, whether it's electrical energy or gasoline, making a bunch of explosions, you got to keep things cool, because if things get too hot, they seize together, they break, they wear out prematurely. You don't want that to happen. You got to have some sort of cooling for your motorcycle. So now we got to talk about what the differences are between air-cooled versus liquid-cooled motorcycles so we can understand which one's better. Well, let's start with how they work differently. Air-cooled motorcycles, if you look at one, it's basically, there's a bunch of little fins. All those fins are called cooling fins, and what happens is cooling fins create more surface area. Why do we want more surface area? Well, air-cooled bikes work by air passing over the engine and cooling it as you're riding. The more surface area you have, the more heat there is. They can get hit by air, which can make the heat dissipate, which can make the whole machine run cooler. But liquid-cooled motorcycles are very different. Liquid-cooled motorcycles, instead, they have more stuff going on. They have radiators, and they have thermostats, and they have little tunnels inside of them where coolant goes through. So, almost like a little sewer system of coolant that just passes through the tubes inside of your motor, so that when there's hot areas and a cool liquid passes over them, it's kind of like hitting your wrist with the hose on a hot summer day, cools down the rest of your body. That's sort of the same idea with how liquid cooling works. So what are the pros and cons of each? Well, let's start with air-cooled bikes. Air-cooled pro, it's really simple and straightforward. There's not a lot going on there. There's not a lot of extra stuff that can break. Con, you're kind of dependent on being moving. You're kind of dependent on there being wind. If you're gonna be stuck in traffic, you run a risk of overheating. And I know, there's a lot of guys who say, I run an air-cooled Harley through the desert all day long at 1,006,000 degrees, and I've never overheated. And I think you're missing the key point, is that you are riding through the desert. If you are riding through the desert, you have air, you have movement, you have the breeze. Even if it's warm air, it's not thousands of degrees warm like it is inside your motor, where things are exploding and being set on fire. So even hot desert air is actually cooler than inside your motor. That's why air-cooled bikes work in the desert. Air-cooled bikes do not work so well in the city, where you're stuck in bumper-to-bumper gridlock in a city like LA, New York, Toronto, etc. Yeah. So let's talk about the pros and cons of liquid-cooled bikes. Well, liquid-cooled bikes, obviously, if you're stuck in a very densely populated area and you're just going bumper-to-bumper traffic, they are still gonna cool. You're gonna hear the fan coming on. Some of them even have little temperature gauges, so you'll see that your bike is never getting too hot, which is kind of nice to see. You have less heat radiating off your bike, making you hotter while you're sitting in traffic, so that's pretty cool. They do say that liquid-cooled bikes tend to last longer, and the reason is because there's less wear on gaskets and stuff. Things are not overheating as much. Things are not being subjected to such extreme temperatures. So in theory, a liquid cooled bike could last longer. That's really gonna depend on a case by case basis, though, I'll give you that much. Downsides, liquid cooled bikes add more complexity. So we have thermostat, those can break. Trust me, I've had to pay for those on my Jeep actually. Yeah, that was not fun. Speaking of Jeeps, you guys like my new background Jeep thing? Check that out. Let me know in the comments if you like it or not. Is it lame? I'm gonna probably hang it on the wall. Let me know if it's lame. All right. Yeah, more cons of the cooled bikes. You have more stuff, more complexity, more things that could break. Your rad could break, your brad could get damaged. Your coolant, I think you have to replace that every like 7,000 miles, something like that. So it's not like a big job, but it is something to worry about to do versus air-cooled bikes. You don't have any maintenance. So those are kind of your pros and cons. Now, the next topic is, of course, which one is best for you? And then we're gonna talk about which one I prefer. So in terms of what's best for you, I think I've made it pretty clear by now. If you are somebody who you live in a city like New York, you live in a city like LA, you live somewhere with crazy traffic, personally, I would recommend a liquid cooled bike. However, if you live pretty much anywhere else, really, an air cooled bike is not the end of the world. Myself, personally, what would I pick? Honestly, I'll put it to you like this. Once upon a time, I was a university student and I always wanted a Harley Sportster. So I sold my liquid-cooled Suzuki Boulevard M50, sold it, and I bought an air-cooled Harley-Davidson Sportster. And my dad was in and out of hospitals in downtown Toronto, and I was working two jobs in downtown Toronto, and I was a university student in downtown Toronto. And I hated my Sportster. I thought I would love it. I thought it was my dream bike. And I hated it because of how miserable I was, because I was just stuck in gridlock, stop-and-go traffic on an air-cooled bike, and it sucked. And what did I do? I sold my air-cooled Harley-Davidson, and I bought another liquid-cooled Suzuki Boulevard M50. However, now I never have to go downtown. I never have to get into the core. So at this point in my life, I would be totally okay with an air-cooled bike. And there's another thing. This is kind of a bonus, because I think I covered everything I said I was going to, but here's a bonus. Jesus Christ. My door just slammed shut on me. Here's kind of a bonus. Air-cooled motorcycles can also be equipped with oil coolers. Oil coolers are a little bit of a different thing. There are all kinds of other things, like Harley has liquid-cooled heads, where just the head is liquid-cooled of the cylinder. But oil coolers will help to cool your oil a little bit. In my opinion, this extra stuff is not great, and here's why. Whether it's like oil coolers for Triumphs, for Ducati Monsters, for all that kind of stuff, while you get a little bit of the cooling benefit, not as much as if you had a proper liquid-cooled motorcycle, you have all of the cons of having a liquid-cooled bike, of more complexity, of having this like rad and thermostat and whatever, maybe just not a fan, but you have all the other stuff and gizmos. But if you got some extra stuff, whatever, that's fine, that's okay too. Basically, I would make this decision based on how much you like the bike you're looking at, what the price is, how well the bike's been looked after, and especially on where and how you're going to be riding it. My name is Adrian from YouMotorcycle.com. If you like this video, please hit like. If you have any questions about air-cooled, liquid-cooled bikes, or questions about anything motorcycle-related that you would like answered, please leave them for me down in the comments. I love answering all you guys' questions, and I'm a big nerd, so I'll probably, if I don't know the answer, I'll probably look it up and write you a whole book report. If you want more motorcycle content aimed at helping you guys, please hit subscribe, and thank you guys for helping me grow my channel. Thanks. Peace.